You know, in the world of teen dramas or TV shows aimed at teens in general, you can kind of sort of break it down into like three phases or eras or whatever. You had TV shows about just teens in high school that was popular in like the 90s and kind of early 2000s. You had sitcoms like Saved by the Bell, or you had teen dramas like Freaks and Geeks. And then later on, you had the supernatural teen drama era that took shape in like the mid to late 2000s. And that gave us like Vampire Diaries, Supernatural, Teen Wolf, Twilight, that kind of thing. Most recently, with the exploding popularity of superhero comic book movies and TV shows and all that, now we're seeing an influx of superhero-themed teen dramas, or, you know, TV shows aimed at teens in general. One of the most recent and most popular shows in this new, like, teen drama phase is the CW's The Flash. So, let's check it out. The show starts out, oddly enough, like pretty much every YouTube vlog ever.
To understand what I'm about to tell you, you need to do something first.
That's right, don't forget to like and subscribe and turn on my notifications. So, Barry Allen is a forensics investigator who's always late for work.
Second robbery this week.
The teller ID'd Clyde Martin as the shooter.
What? Oh, jeez, the Martin brothers are back.
What do we got?
Perps took the bank, shot out the cameras, and as a chaser, killed the security guard over there. I got unis kicking in doors of known Martin Brothers associates.
CSI been over it?
No.
Where's Alan?
Do you get it, kids? Do you get it? He's the Flash, the fastest man alive, but he's always late for stuff. Do you get the joke? Do you get it, kids? Hilarious!
CSI, coming
he's
through.
He's not here now. I'm gonna have to carry on this investigation without him.
Sorry I'm late, Captain Singh.
What was it this time, Mr. Allen? Did you forget to set your alarm clock? Before you answer, I should remind you, the excuse you gave last time was car trouble. Wanna know why that one was particularly memorable?
I do not own a car.
He was running an errand for me. Barry, did you get me what I asked for?
You mean this life-size body pillow of Dr. Robotnik in lingerie? Are you kidding? Of course I did! After picking up some CSI gunk or whatever, he heads back to his lab where we meet Iris, his longtime childhood friend whose dad is the police chief guy and Barry's boss. Now, the conversation they have here is maybe one of my biggest pet peeves when I'm watching any TV show or movie or whatever.
I'm stress eating over my dissertation. If I don't graduate soon, I'm gonna be more muffin top than woman.
You look amazing.
What is so important about this particle accelerator anyway?
Harrison Wells' work in quantum theory is light years ahead of anything they're doing at CERN.
You're doing that thing where you're not speaking English.
You see, this right here, this is one of those like TV show movie tropes that's been around since forever, and it always annoys me when it comes up. Whenever a nerdy character says anything like remotely scientific or even just like smart, and then everyone else is like, ugh, in English, please. Like, this trope is used to accomplish two things. One, it allows all of us to make fun of nerds in a comic book TV show. I don't know who thought that was a good idea. And two, it means the writers of the show assume that we, the audience, are just too dumb to understand anything about above like a third grade level. I mean, just look at Big Bang Theory, right? The most popular show on TV right now, and it's literally just in English, Egon, the TV show.
Okay, just imagine that dot is everything the human race has ever learned until this moment.
Does that include twerking?
Really? You're just gonna say that and just leave it there? So later that day, Barry and Iris go to Star Labs, where we see not Elon Musk unveiling his new particle accelerator thing, but not before Barry decides he's finally gonna tell Iris how he really feels.
While I was away, I had a chance to think about, you know, relationships.
Even though we pretty much grew up in the same house together and we're kind of like brother and sister, because we're not brother and sister, it can get really weird and awkward to talk to me about girls, but I just want you to know that it shouldn't be awkward. There is nothing that I want more than for you to meet the right person that totally loves and adores you for the amazing guy that you are.
Friendzone smash.
Oh no, now I have to listen to her talk about boy problems and pretend to care and give her advice for the rest of my life. They finally turn on the particle accelerator thing, and surprise, surprise, it blows up, sending a shockwave through the entire city and hitting Barry with a lightning bolt. Now, Barry wakes up 9 months later in Star Labs with not Elon Musk and his team of kids looking after him.
Hey, what is happening? What is going on?
You were struck by lightning, dude.
Lightning gave me abs.
Your muscles should be atrophied, but instead they're in a chronic and unexplained state of cellular regeneration.
And trust me, I know. I checked your abs really thoroughly. Like, really thorough. Barry leaves the lab and somehow knows exactly where Iris is, even though he's been in a coma for 9 months. I mean, let's be honest, that's the real superpower here.
I'm not crying, you're crying. Shut up.
Here, Barry starts to realize he has superpowers and goes back to Star Abs.
Star Labs.
To figure out what's going on. So, not Elon Musk and his team set out to test the extent of his new powers. But of course, during the test, things don't go so well.
What happened out there today? You were moving pretty well, and then something caused you to lose focus? I started remembering something. When I was 11, my mother was murdered.
Whoa, kid, hey, I thought maybe you just had like a fight with your girlfriend or something. Like, I didn't sign up for this guided tour of your whole life story, all right?
But what if the man who killed my mom was like me?
A skinny nerdy kid with a really attractive friend and a butt chin? Pfft, what are the odds of that? Now later, Barry is stalking Iris, I assume, because somehow he always knows exactly where she is, like all the time. And here we learn that she is now dating her dad's new partner. And as you can imagine, Barry's not too happy about it.
When you were in the hospital, Eddie covered my father's shift so that we could both be with you. I thanked him with a cup of coffee and things just kind of happened.
What do you mean things just happened? Hey. Here's a cup of coffee. Thanks. Wanna make out? Okay. Anyway, it turns out Barry wasn't the only one who got special powers that night, and some ne'er-do-wells have decided to use their powers to, like, rob banks and stuff. Barry decides to take matters into his own hands and put a stop to it. When Monster of the Week number one decides to summon a tornado and terrorize the city, Barry thinks it's a good idea to run around the tornado the opposite way to stop it, instead of just, you know, running into the tornado and stopping the guy in the middle who's actually making the thing in the first place. Now, shockingly, his plan actually works, and in the end, Iris's dad finds out that Barry is indeed the Flash. You know, I guess technically this show isn't really a teen drama per se because, like, there aren't any teens in the show, but, like, it pulls a lot of the same tropes anyway. So, I mean, like, it might as well be a teen drama, you know what I'm saying? But much like how the supernatural teen dramas are all pretty much, like, the same show, just, like, with different characters, you know? Almost every superhero movie and TV show, like, it's really just the same show. Nerdy slash outsider loser kid suddenly wakes up with abs and tries to adjust to their new life of having the physique, but none of the social skills. But, you know, when you get right down to it, superpowers have basically become the new, like, brooding vampire shtick or whatever. Not that there's anything necessarily wrong with that, but I'm just saying, we've kind of been here before. Hey, guess what? This video is brought to you by Audible. So hey, it's 2018, and I'm guessing most of you are already pretty behind on those, like, New Year's resolutions you made, like, 2 months ago. Unless you're like me, and you don't make New Year's resolutions because you're perfect! No, but really, everyone's busy in finding time to grow and improve yourself while working and or going to school. I get it, it's tough. Well, audiobooks are a fantastic way to turn your boring commutes to work into a chance to learn something new or just improve your knowledge on certain topics that interest you. And of course, the leader in the audiobook industry is Audible. Now, for those of you out there who don't know, Audible is a service that lets you download from thousands upon thousands of audiobooks. Science fiction, self-help, fantasy, nonfiction, biographies, whatever you like, they got it. And right now, if you sign up with my link here, that's audible.com/AlexMeyers, or you can text my name, Alex Meyers, to 500-500. You get one free audiobook and a free 30-day trial. So really, you got nothing to lose. Now, since I work full-time and I make videos full-time, I don't get to sleep very much. So I'm actually currently listening to The Sleep Revolution by Arianna Huffington. Sleep is something that's always been hard for me to do for some reason, and I've actually learned quite a lot from this book already. So if you're like me and you always feel like a zombie from The Walking Dead, check it out. Or you know what? If you listen to audio books,
or if you use my link to get one for free,
let me know in the comments what you're listening to, or like, what would you recommend? Not just for me, but like, for anyone. Again, you get a free audiobook and a free 30 days with Audible if you use my link, audible.com/AlexMeyers, or text Alex Meyers to 500-500 and turn your once boring car or train rides into the highlight of your day. You know, when I started making these videos, like, you know, such and such is a mess, or such and such is kind of dumb, whatever, like, you know, originally it started out like, it was like a thesis statement, like, Riverdale is a mess, or PLL is kind of dumb, like, that was like the point of the video. But now it's kind of evolved into this, like, the name of the video was just kind of like a series, I guess, in a way, like, it, you know, if I have a video and it's like, such and such is kind of dumb, like, it's not that I necessarily think it's dumb, it's just it's kind of part of this series where I watch dramas and TV shows and movies, whatever, and I kind of talk about them, you know? You know, for example, this video about The Flash, like, you know, I didn't hate The Flash at all. Like, I thought it was actually quite good. It was interesting, but I mean, it was kind of derivative and kind of like whatever, you know, like I talked about in the video, but like, I don't really think it's actually dumb. It's just kind of the name of the video. It's part of the series, I guess. So, like, I hope that's kind of clear to people. I know, like, I keep getting new people joining in. And, you know, welcome. I hope you enjoy the videos. But, you know, like, with Supernatural, people are like, oh, with that title, you're going to get a lot of hate on that video. And I don't know if I did or not. But I hope people kind of realize that the naming conventions are just part of a series. It's not really, like, the thesis statement of the video. You know what I mean? It's kind of evolved into that. I hope that's clear. But if it's not, that's what it is now. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget, you know, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Twitter. Tweet me, DM me, whatever. I always try to reply to everything I get. Follow my dog, Charlie, on Instagram. It's Charlie Meets Pumpkin. Check out the Patreon if you're interested. You know, $5 a month, you get some behind-the-scenes stuff. You get a look at thumbnails early. You get to look at scripts and, you know, new pictures I'm drawing, things like that. So if you're interested in that, check it out. If not, it's totally fine. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.